I thought I'd do another video. You know, Australia is such a hot country, a hot and humid country. Here it is, the middle of autumn, and it's stinking hot again, 31 degrees. I mean, I find personally the heat and humidity here is just too much. And I think Australia is unbearable in summer, no matter where you are. I think it's just a hot country. I think it's in the wrong location in the world. And it's a landmass that just sits in the wrong area. It's too much in the hot areas of the world. And the humidity here is just insufferable. I mean, here it is in the middle of April, the 15th of April, and another round of stinking hot weather. You know, it'll be good to be able to go somewhere at least that has a different feel about it. I prefer colder weather and colder climate, but personally, I haven't got much choice in where I can decide to live. You know, I was out doing a bike ride just a while ago, and I came across another young guy who claimed to me he was a confident atheist. And I thought to myself, well, okay, if man, he says that man knows everything, science can prove everything, science can explain everything. Well, excuse me, if man is so perfect, then how come there's wars? How come there's famine? How come there's other problems in the world that are related to man? You know, this so-called monetary system that man has set up, that's supposed to be, you know, perfect and workable. How come there's so many people that are bound by poverty and so many people that are destitute and poor? And how come there's famine in the world? If man's so perfect, how come there are people that can't, you know, they can't live in accommodation and they can't afford the cost of living? And, you know, this guy said to me, oh, well, he was worked for superannuation. He said, oh, well, I can explain everything, why the superannuation's gone down. If you look at the last 10 years, you can see that there's been improvement and now it's gone down. I find Brisbane is such a really narrow place. It's, you know, it's a really narrow environment. And to be honest with you, you know, I love people of faith. I love being in faith because there's a lot of beauty and love and acceptance from my own faith in Christianity. But when someone comes along and says they're a confident atheist, well, how can they explain their own birth? Has man actually created a human being? He might have created one in a test tube. But the whole process of creating a person in God's image, surely that was done by God. And the world around us, the so-called Big Bang Theory, that all these scientists say that they're so expert in being able to get up and confidently say created the universe, I find it hard to fathom that a whole universe was actually created by a small speck that exploded. Where exactly did this come from? Where did this originate from? So if you're saying you're a confident atheist, well, and how can you explain the universe coming into existence? How can you explain life itself? How can you explain the very composition of the planets and nature and the life and the fact that when there is God and there is love, there's happiness? And it's proven people do survive and function and adapt more in a positive, loving environment. And that is the very essence of the soul that God gives us. Anyway, when I had a brief chat to this guy, he said, oh, look, have a nice day. This is the thing, that atheists can only go so far and they can't continue anymore with discussion because they know that their argument is going to go nowhere. They can just say man is an expert, he's an all, and science can prove everything because Stephen Hawking said, oh, well, this God was all a mathematical formula, you know, was God can be proven math that doesn't exist mathematically. But is there, you know, maths explain everything, you know? And as I said, you know, Stephen Hawking was blessed to have more years in his life and to have the phenomenal memory he had. Where did he get that from? A mathematical equation? But anyway, I'm not going to go into that. I don't want to judge because I've already sinned by judging. But I just find it frustrating when And I think Australia is an atheist country, very atheist and secular. And I think that those of us with faith have a hard battle in this place. And I think it's no, and the biggest hatred towards Christianity and the persecution of Christians doesn't come from other religious denominations solely and completely. It comes from the hatred of the Caucasian, demographics, probably the young generation and perhaps the older generation, that absolutely hate and despise Christianity. And I've heard it from people I've known. I've heard it from people in congregations. They have a wife, they have a friend, they have a brother, they have a cousin, they have a what have you. They have people that do not believe in God. They have, they're adamant in their ways of thinking and their ways of functioning, and that's it. They don't believe, they don't want to believe, and they don't even want to accept the fact that Jesus said, I am the way, the life, and the truth. They don't even want to believe that. And in the very, very passage where Jesus said in the Bible, my kingdom is not of this world, you know, doesn't that make you realize that there is a God and a loving world beyond this world? But, you know, I just get fed up with being around these so-called confident atheists or around these atheists. I mean, I just, you know, one atheist told me, oh, evolution existed, man was just a babe and he got lucky. Where's the evidence? Where's the evidence to prove that? Where's the evidence? So I just say to the atheist, where's the evidence? And that's all I have to say. And I really do feel that like, it is challenging living in this world when you have a faith. It's a hard battle, and not only do you have to battle with people, I've also had to battle with Satan, and I can assure you it's not a pleasant experience, and it still isn't a pleasant experience, but I know that my soul is with God and my love is with God. And, you know, I'm prepared, as Jesus did, to go out of this world the way that he did. And people can say, oh, you know, I feel sorry, I'm concerned about your well-being. Well, I'm happy where I am. I know that I have my faith and the Holy Spirit in me. I know that when I went to church this morning, I felt great going to church and listening to the gospel. I felt like I did my duty to God and to worship. And I just don't have time for atheists and confident atheists. You know, you can live your life and you may not have time for me, but really, I think it's time to sort of probably open your mind a little bit more and to actually read the Bible and study it before dismissing it and saying you haven't read it or saying you've read it and you can't talk about it anymore. God bless you.